But I would like to take the time to bring to the stage the lady responsible for us all being here tonight. Yes, yes. She is an amazing person. We've been working on this project for months. She really has a heart of gold. She's a hard worker. She's a great mom. She's so smart and made me see how unsmart I really am, you know, by working with her. So please, with all the energy you have, please put your hands together for the lady responsible for us being here tonight. And she has an MBA, by the way. Please put your hands together for the lovely and talented Melanie Stovall.
Awesome introduction, Mel. Thank you so much.
Thank you all.
It's funny though, because as we were having the conversations, planning and doing all of that, and I said, Mel, I want an introduction like how Steve Harvey brought out one of the kings of comedy. He hails from Massachusetts. I want the red carpet royal treatment when you introduced me, but that was great. That was awesome. Thank you, Mel. I appreciate that. I am, let's see, notes here. Okay. So good evening, ladies and gentlemen and little people. Welcome to the first annual Legacy Bridges Foundation Bridging the Gap Award Celebration and Fundraising Gala. Thank you to each and every one of you for being here this evening as we embark on a twofold celebration, an historical evening to celebrate the tremendous work of six distinguished individuals. Honorees who are passionate, committed, and have dedicated their lives to making our world a better place. Tonight, we celebrate their heart, their stick-to-itiveness, determination, sacrifice, and commitment to bridging the gap in order to create a legacy that will last for generations to come. While simultaneously, we will acknowledge that November is National Epilepsy Awareness Month, and will draw attention to the disease that affects one in every 26 individuals. Coming together this evening is to shine a light on the many families and individuals that are affected by this neurological disorder. The Legacy Bridges Foundation is a California 501c3 nonprofit public benefit corporation founded to support individuals and families that suffer with epilepsy and other seizure-related disorders. Our mission is to raise awareness about the disease of epilepsy and shine a light for those individuals who have been impacted by the disease and partner with other organizations to find a cure. Now you may be wondering, why are we so passionate about this work? How did we get involved in this mission? And I'm so glad you asked that question, thank you. The passion behind our work stems from my daughter's 13-year battle with this disease that has since left her immobile. From writing the memoir, The Life Heist, Journey of a Childhood Robbed by the Unknown, under the pseudonym L. Bridges, detailing our extensive and very exhaustive trauma, hope, determination, and strength journey, and the fight for answers, healing, and a better way of life. Through sharing our story, we discovered that there are so many other people experiencing the same traumas, the same isolation, the same search for answers. And so we thought, what best way to give back to those we understood than to start a foundation? So, similar to an earthquake, a seizure can happen at any moment, anywhere, at any time with varying effects. Epilepsy sees no color, no age, gender, social status, and essentially it doesn't matter who you are. From NFL players, high profile celebrities, to elected officials, CEOs, directors, to students and little ones, it's confirmed just how non-discriminatory this disease truly is. And for that reason, it is our desire to help alleviate the pain, and it is our life's work to alleviate the impact and make an impact. And that impact leads to why we are here this evening. Our theme, Bridging the Gap, is a significant, powerful, and all-encompassing concept of us coming together to create a pipeline, a channel, to which provides better quality of life for our communities. I can't help but to take a moment and to scan the room and just to acknowledge the level of influence in this place this evening. Representation from all professions, such as medicine, education, presidents, directors, philanthropists, pastors, entrepreneurs. Collectively, there's a wide range of experience and support in this space this evening. And I get chill bumps at the thought of what we could all accomplish together. And I'm sure you're all aware that the Inland Empire is one of the fastest growing regions in California. And because of this, new successes, challenges, and opportunities surface and reveal the immense needs of our communities. With diversity, equity, and inclusion being a huge topic, new collaborations have been formed to solve major problems, to ensure that health and wellness of our families and communities is a top priority. Each one of us here tonight contributes to bridging a gap in some capacity or another. It takes the work of us all to build a bridge that is stable with a solid foundation and structured to weather the test of time, to be the nexus that our communities so desperately need. We commend you for your devotion to the work that each of you performs day in and day out to serve others. The lives that you are touching, the impact you are making, does not go unnoticed. We all were called to do a great work, and you have answered the call. We've all answered the call. And kudos to each individual under the sound of my voice. Thank you. Thank you for your unwavering commitment to carry out the work that you were called to do. We need you. Our communities need you. So give yourselves a round of applause, for you all deserve to be recognized tonight. And so before we begin tonight's presentation, I would like to acknowledge the individuals, or a few individuals, who could not be here with us physically to partake of this celebration. And we sense your presence and thank you for supporting us. I would also like to specifically acknowledge our board of directors, advisory board members, executive staff, volunteers, sponsors, and supporters. But without your commitment to our mission, we could not do the work that we do day in and day out. Thank you for the grace that you've shown us. Thank you for believing in our mission. Thank you for shining your light so that we can shine our light for others. Your passion and commitment to the Legacy Bridges Foundation is truly appreciated. There are not enough words to express our sincerest gratitude for your support. Thank you so, so much. Awesome, okay. All right, so before we begin our words presentation, allow me to preface with the meaning and symbolism of our words design. The light. You honorees are the light that illuminates the path for others to follow. You have ignited a flame for other generations to seamlessly identify the pathway to success. You endured the trials, adversities, anguish, and pushed forward. You pushed through to fulfill your promise to the world. You identified the need and took the lead to make an impactful change. You continuously worked towards building a legacy that will last for generations to come. The path that you paved, brick by brick, stone by stone, pillar by pillar, honorees, each of you have exhibited triumph, excellence, courage, tenacity, and diligence along your journeys to arrive to this very moment tonight. And in addition to the awards being presented tonight, honorees, each of you will receive certificates of recognition from the offices of other distinguished elected officials, such as Eloise Gomez-Reyes, Assembly Majority Leader, 47th District, and our esteemed honoree, Aquanetta Warren, Mayor, City of Fontana, and the Fontana City Council, and also Supervisor Rutherford, 2nd District, San Bernardino County Board of Supervisors, Jeff Hewitt, Chairman, 5th District, Riverside County Board of Supervisors, Deborah Robertson, Mayor, City of Rialto, and Rialto City Council, and Mike A. Gibson, Assembly Member, 64th District. And all of those are personalized certificates for each of you, acknowledging the special work and the tremendous work that you all are doing in your communities. And with that being said, I, with great pleasure, would like to announce our first honoree this evening, Fontana City Mayor Aquanetta Warren. Mayor Aquanetta Warren is recipient of the Legacy Award for her achievements in civic leadership. This award is given to individuals who guide and inspire significant long-term contributions dedicated to supporting community growth and development a pillar in the community that leverages collaboration, inclusiveness, innovation, and civic engagement to address issues and foster change, who embodies community service, demonstrates outstanding civic and charitable responsibility, and whose philanthropic achievements have left legacy-driven footprints on Inland Empire communities, cities, and beyond. On October 25th, let me add this really quick, Mayor Warren and the Fontana City Council presented the Legacy Bridges Foundation with a proclamation proclaiming that November 2022 is National Epilepsy Awareness Month, and invited residents to gain an understanding of epilepsy and how it affects those around them. We are still on cloud nine from this tremendous honor and appreciate Mayor Warren and the Fontana City Council for recognizing our continuous commitment to raise awareness about epilepsy and to support those in need. Thank you so much, Mayor.
Thank you so much. This is really an honor for not only myself, but our great city of over 215,000 people. Several years ago, I started a program called Healthy Fontana, and part of it wasn't just health resources. So when you came across my desk, I saw a resource for our citizens. Mm. I grew up with several friends and family that had this disease, but I don't call it a disease, I call it an episode, because episodes change. So thank you for the great work you're doing to make sure that happens.
Talk about her credits. And I'm going to tell you, it was probably about 80 pages long. This lady has done a lot over the years for the communities. She has a TV show called Open for Business. There is also she created the Mayor's Manufacturing Council. But here's the biggest thing. She was elected back in 2010, re-elected in 2014, re-elected in 2018, and God willing, re-elected in 2022.
All right. Please. Wonderful. So now for our next honoree. I am beyond excited to announce our next honoree this evening, Mrs. Kimberly Anthony. Mrs. Kimberly Anthony Morrow is the recipient of the Bridging the Gap and Academic Achievement Award. This award is given to individuals who not only encourage academic excellence, but have dedicated their life to transforming the lives of individuals who invest in their lifelong learning, whose commitment is to use experience, philosophy, and innovation to create a pathway for others to access, navigate, and succeed in becoming the best versions of themselves, who displays qualities of servant leadership and altruism, and demonstrates outstanding charitable responsibility, community service, and whose philanthropic achievements have left legacy-driven footprints on the lives of those she serves. Kimberly develops a pathway for those of historically marginalized communities to access world-class transformational education. I am beyond honored to introduce this very special individual. Y'all all need to get to know Ms. Kimberly. Have her number in your phone. Just saying. But Ms. Kimberly, we honor you this evening for the work that you're doing.
I nothing but gratitude, and I would be remiss if I did not thank my family, Tamia, Talise, Tanika, Chucky, and our extended family at the table, my hubby, Tommy, my church family, Ray Ballinger, and Tina Moore. Wow, it's just what you are doing. What am I doing? I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. In the last couple years, I had the privilege of championing close to 400 nonprofit organizations. Woo! And never have, and Melanie was a part of that program, never have I seen someone take their vision and committed to making a difference, and not just study, but put that study and that philosophy and those principles in action. And now we are here. This time last year, this did not exist. Let's give it up for Melody. And powerful mother, Melody. Education, there's different types of education. I know we all know. I've been passionate as an emancipated foster kid. I needed to learn everything I could to create a life that I would like myself for. And that led me to coaching. And after 30 years of working in the transformation industry, working in personal growth and development, and doing whatever I can to support people and being the best version of themselves, the pandemic hit. And there I was, sitting on a sofa, wondering how I could make a difference from here. And I decided that I would offer coaching. Got overwhelmed and said, we need some partners in progress. 60 people signed up for our first coaching academy. And we were accredited by the International Coach Federation, which is the gold standard for coach accreditation worldwide. Our graduates can work in corporate, they can work in government agencies, they got scholarships if they made a commitment to giving back to those who are reimagining their lives, people who were navigating what we call their new next. One of those people was Melanie Stovall. She not only stepped up and participated in our nonprofit cohort, she participated as in our coaching cohort, and she is using that knowledge to touch, move, and inspire people who are going through difficult times to empower them with wisdom that she got on her own. One more time for Melanie Stovall. Okay. Our next honoree this evening has a heart of gold, Mrs. Sherry Bogue. Mrs. Sherry Bogue is a recipient of the Bridging the Gap Community Hero Award. This award is given to individuals who have dedicated their life to a cause bigger than themselves, whose commitment is to protect, aid, and be in service to vulnerable individuals or groups in ways that provide security, hope, and inspiration, who displays qualities of servant leadership and altruism, and demonstrates outstanding charitable responsibility, community service, and whose philanthropic achievements have left legacy-driven footprints on the lives of those they serve. This is Sherry Ball, ladies and gentlemen.
Absolutely. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm very honored, very humbled to be here, especially amongst so many honored and distinguished honorees. Melanie came to tour our facility a couple of months ago, and we were driving all around 126 acres of our property. We work for an organization called Child Help. We're a short-term residential facility treatment center in Beaumont for children of abuse and neglect. And during the tour, Melanie kept saying, "Wow, I'm so impressed with your facility and all that your organization does." But the more I got to talking to Melanie and the more questions I asked, it was I who was impressed with Melanie. To take such a leap of faith and jump out and start her own organization is such an act of courage. And I just want to tell you that I accept this on behalf of all of Child Help, the staff and the kids. I wouldn't be here tonight without my boss and my friend and my mentor, Jamie Crabtree, right here. And I look forward to our new partnership together and working many, many years down the road. Yes. Thank you.
Mr. Elton L. Garrett Jr. is the recipient of the Founders Choice Award for his extraordinary commitment and dedication in supporting the Legacy Bridges Foundation and our mission. Elton is also to be recognized for his renowned service to making San Bernardino and Riverside County communities and beyond a better place through his civic and philanthropic work. Thank you so much.
First of all, I want to thank the Academy. I'm sorry. That's the wrong one. Thank you, Melanie. I met Melanie at an event, I don't know how long ago, and right off the bat, she just looked at me and said, sit down, you know, so. So I sat, and I've been there ever since, so whenever she calls, I answer, and I show up, and I write my check and send it in and do whatever, whatever she tells me to do, and all, but in all sincerity, I love what she's doing. I think it's a wonderful, wonderful thing for the community and for what these young people and older people need and everything. So on behalf of myself, on behalf of the Westside Action Group, and specifically on behalf of Garrett Management Group, we're so happy to be a part of this, and we welcome to do anything and anything that we can to help out of whatever needs to be done. Thank you.
You know, I would gladly introduce our next, not so much an honoree, but an amazing, hardworking entrepreneur, wife, and mother of four to share her family's journey with epilepsy. Please welcome to the stage, Mrs. Brandy Young.
Hello, everyone. Hello. I am honored to be given the chance to tell my daughter Brina's story. So, when I was delivering her, the pain was intense, guys. And I was having trouble pushing, and the nurse told me her heart rate was dropping. So I gave a big push, and my daughter Brina was born. She was just perfect. She passed all of her tests at the hospital, and I was able to bring her home. I began my journey as a mother, and everything was great until she turned about 6 months. My mom noticed something wasn't right. Then I was told by the daycare center that she wasn't meeting all of her milestones. That's when I noticed she wasn't doing the things the other kids were doing. And she started having the twitching in her face and jerking that would throw her into a flip. I took her to the doctor, and they did some testing, and everything came back normal. But she was showing signs of seizures. She was put on seizure medication, and my whole world was turned upside down. I spent the next couple of years searching for answers. As she got older, her seizures got worse. She started having grand mal seizures. She was put on seizure medication. And I spent the next couple of years just trying to figure out what exactly that was wrong with her. She started having grand mal seizures, I said that, which is more like convulsions. When she turned 10, we finally got a diagnosis, which was epilepsy and cerebral palsy. Even though the doctors couldn't really tell me why this was happening, I was content that I finally had an answer. This journey has been a challenge and a joy. Brina has taught me compassion and understanding. She taught me how to love unconditionally, and God knew I needed an angel, and he blessed me with an amazing support team, my family.
So just to share a little bit about how we met, on Facebook, actually, social yes. media is what connected us. And since then, Brandy and I try to get together at least once a month, just, you know, let our hair down, have a good time, you know, have lunch, things like that. And how amazing that moment for us with, you know, work, kids, school, everything,
yes, everything,
to just disconnect and be able to connect in a way that we need,
yes.
right? As mothers, we tend to put ourselves on the back burner to take care of our families. And it's important that we take that time to re-engage, to just to re-energize
yes.
and refresh. And so what I like to do moving forward is to add more moms to our monthly get together, so that way we can spread that joy and that relief that other moms may need. And we can just have fun, you know, go
yes,
tear out the town.
Definitely.
yes.
yes, I love it.
Yes, and so what I wanted to do, just a small token, just to say thank you and how we appreciate the work that you're doing in your, with your families, with your communities, but just thank you. Acknowledge the work that you are doing.
Thank you.
All right, so moving right along with our presentation, our next prestigious honoree this evening is the incredible Mrs. Naikani Tadimi. Ms. Nakani Tadimi is a recipient of the Bridging the Gap Community Empowerment Award. This award is given to individuals whose commitment is to empower specific community members through inclusion, social development, engagement, and community service that demonstrates understanding and importance of social value, and whose philanthropic achievements have left legacy-driven footprints on the lives of those they serve. Nakani is to be commended for creating social and physical opportunities for those of the special needs community to challenge themselves to see past their limitations to create lasting memories.
I feel honored to be standing here before all of you today. I would like to say thank you to Melanie and the Legacy Bridges Foundation for thoughtful recognition. And we're so excited to have you in Deja, part of the Special Stars family. A very big thank you to my amazing Special Stars family and staff. They're sitting here with me today. Words cannot express how much you all mean to me. The Snoop Special Stars will continue to do our best to change the negative stereotypes associated with the special needs community. And I want to give a huge thank you to Coach Snoop, who couldn't be here tonight, for being our number one supporter and believing in the Special Stars' vision and our mission. Last but not least, I would like to thank my two wonderful children and friends for being here with me tonight. I would also like to thank you guys for your love, support, and encouragement during this tough time in my life. You guys know what I'm talking about. And I know that my mom is very proud and smiling down on me.
So our next distinguished honoree this evening is the exceptional Miles Levin. Miles Levin is the recipient of the Bridging the Gap in Media Excellence Award. This award is given to individuals whose commitment is to utilize unique strategies to develop powerful messaging and efforts to raise awareness about epilepsy through media platforms. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Miles Levin.
Thank you all for coming tonight. I want to thank you, Melanie. This is beautiful. I want to thank my dad for bringing me here tonight, and Mel. Mel, you made really intense eye contact with me when you were talking about kicking your kids out of the house. And I imagine we have some discussing to do after this, but I suppose I'd like to thank both of my dads for bringing me here tonight. But for real, I didn't really ever want to talk about epilepsy when I was younger. I was diagnosed at about 4 years old, and I saw close to 100 doctors before I was 18 years old, about which time Mel would have kicked me out of the house. I didn't really have a normal childhood. I was one of the one-third of people with epilepsy who just do not respond to medication, and my parents' lives were very altered completely by my diagnosis. And continue to be. And I remember being asked if I wanted to attend a camp for kids who had seizures when I was about 17. And I didn't want to go. I didn't want anything to do with the thing I liked the least about myself. Why would I want to go spend a week thinking about the thing I like least about myself? And 10 years later, that was the most important thing that I ever did, was go to that camp. Because I was forced to reckon with all of me. And I met all of these kids who they'd be my age, and they'd tell me they'd never made a friend before. And you know, epilepsy is, as you know, it affects one in 26 people will have epilepsy in their lifetime. And we talk in this community a lot about the cure, and which is difficult because it's not our decision, you know, it's someone else's work. You know, it's it's that one doctor in the back of the room that maybe has something to do about it. But there's two cures. There's the cure for seizures, but the cure for epilepsy is empathy. And the experience of having epilepsy is the time in between seizures. It's the time before and after the seizure when you're living in a world that refuses to include you. And so, much to my parents' dismay, I'm a filmmaker, and I made a lot of really ridiculous stuff. And after that couple of camp experiences, I went for 7 years, I realized that while I can't cure seizures, I could maybe fix stigma. And the suicide rate, the homelessness with people with epilepsy is through the roof compared on the national average to the rest of the pie. These kids that are 15 years old and they've never made a friend before, it has nothing to do with their diagnosis. It has to do with a world that just does not have the information. That most people identify as good people. Most people, they want to be a part of the solution. They just can't react with their humanity when they're faced with something that they've never seen before. And the only time they've seen a seizure before is in a hospital show or in a horror movie. Of course they feel that way. I can't even feel bad. Of course they feel that way. So I wanted to make a film, and you're gonna show it. It's about a boy with epilepsy who he's so desperate to feel like a regular kid, he goes to prom knowing that the lights will make him have a seizure. And I wanted to make this because, one, I wanted kids with epilepsy to see on screen someone like them, because that power is life-changing. But I hate to say, more importantly, I need people on the outside of this room to have a reason to connect with someone like us, and that movies and television are some of the only places in culture where people actually go out of their way to see and hear from someone they've never heard or seen before. And so that's why I do what I do, and I say sometimes I want to wake up one morning and say I'm really glad I have epilepsy, because it gets me involved in my community and it makes what I've been through matter. And it's moments like this where I really do feel that way. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh.
Yeah,
we're about to play your film. So we're gonna play his film, guys. Right.
Hello?
Please tell me this is the boys' room.
Okay, time to go.
Hey, is your hair wet?
Get out.
I can't.
Jesus, come on. Ah! Oh my God! I'll call somebody.
No, don't.
I'll call like an ambulance,
no,
or something.
Don't.
I'm so sorry.
Don't.
I'm so sorry.
Do you know Shelby Powell? Can you go tell her that I'll be right out? And I didn't forget.
What's your emergency?
Yeah, this guy hurt his shoulder.
No.
I think he needs
no.
help.
Hang up.
Conscious?
Hang up.
Yeah, he said he dislocated it.
Come on, hang up!
Why are you in here?
What's the address? Ma'am? Hello?
Please go talk to Shelby. She's saving it to answer me. Please, no ambulance. Look, look, I got this, I got this.
What? Stop! Stop! Stop!
They'll call my mom.
Are you kidding me?
I'm really, really not supposed to be here.
In the girls' bathroom, imagine that.
At prom.
Do you even go here?
Your mascara is running.
So my boyfriend making out with someone.
Sorry.
So? How many beers did it take to get you into the girls' bathroom?
I don't drink. I have seizures.
Tell me where?
Sam.
Sam, will you tell me where you're going?
Hang up. No.
Sam, tell me it's not dangerous.
You're good. 911, please state your emergency.
Okay, okay. This guy's having a seizure.
They'll call my mom.
Sam?
Check to see if he's carrying any epilepsy medication.
It would kill her. It'll kill her.
What is your location?
We're at Sullivan Valley High.
An ambulance should be there within 3 minutes. Stay where you are, okay?
They say that they'll be here in 3 minutes. Would make you have a seizure.
Because it's worth it.
A dumb dance is worth having a seizure?
Yeah.
just want to be normal. One time. Once.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. He didn't know.
Been together for 3 years and I couldn't take it. I'm sorry.
You can't just leave like a normal person.
I wouldn't blame you if you hated me for it.
It's kind of awesome, actually.
What?
It's badass. Who has a breakup story like that?
You're gonna have a seizure no matter what at this point, right? Do you wanna go to prom with me? It's okay. It's okay. But only if you want to. You don't have to.
Can I borrow your phone?
You're probably scared. I went to prom, Mom. Just like everybody else. It's just hard. I don't want to get hurt, but I'm tired of missing out. I know I'll never be a normal kid. I don't have to wonder.
Film, Miles, is amazing. Thank you so much. I wasn't gonna do this because my daughter's journey has been very, very, very traumatic. And we found that a lot of people have different experiences with epilepsy, and it affects everyone differently. But it's just, it's situations like this where you meet other people, you connect with them who understand the journey. And to be able to hear their story and something in it you can relate to. And what I love about this film is that it's not just the epilepsy story. You all can connect with it in some capacity, right? The prom, who doesn't want to go to the prom? Everybody wants to go to the prom. And so, Miles, I appreciate you for sharing your story and for opening the door for other children to share their story. You're like their hero, right? You were at Disneyland the other day with them during National Epilepsy Day. and to see the photos of your interaction with the kids, you are changing lives. And the work that you're doing and the work that we're doing and we all can come together, we are gonna make an impactful difference. We are gonna change the game. We really are. And I can't say thank you enough. Even how we met, it's interesting, this journey that I've been on with the foundation and connecting with even folks like Sherry and just being able to be in the right place at the right time and meeting those people who can help you get to that next level or help bridge the gap so that way you can help other people. So I just want to thank you all, and it's probably not where I'm supposed to be right now, Mel, so forgive me for going off script. But I just wanted to take that moment to thank you for believing in what we're doing enough to even be here tonight with us, for opening the email that we sent you, for responding to the text message, for maybe having to find a babysitter so that you and your spouse could be here this evening. We appreciate the sacrifice that you all made in being here tonight. And now you know a little bit about our journey and why we are so passionate about the work we're doing. And it may not affect you immediately. And we've seen that out in the battle. We're doing community outreach that some people just kind of blow by our table. I don't know anybody who has seizures. Well, I didn't know anybody either until it kind of bust down the door of my home and affected our family. So I say that to say you may know someone in your inner circle. You may know someone, an acquaintance, a coworker, someone at your kid's school or your church family that may be suffering with seizures and just needs that support of someone who can understand their journey. So share our information. Make sure that you let them know they can text us, they can email us, they can call us, whatever that looks like. We're here. We're here and we're not going anywhere. As Kimberly kind of mentioned, it's only been a year on paper that we've officially been established, and we've been doing so much, and we have plans to go even higher. And I'm really floored at how this time last year we were, you know, putting things together, and look where we're at this evening. And if this gala is this amazing this year, can you imagine next year? Oh my goodness. But thank you all so much. I appreciate you. The pledge, yes, so please support our mission. Raising awareness, as you've seen, we've even connected with politicians, and they're supporting our vision and our mission. And so if you all could contribute to it in any way that you can, a monthly contribution, $5, $10, $100, whatever it is that you can give, we will greatly appreciate it. And as we are fundraising to purchase a van so that we can transport our disabled champions to and from social outings and medical appointments and things of the sort, we want to get our champions out of the house. We want to let them know it is okay to still live a life. Although you're battling with a seizure disorder, you can still come out and play. And we want to take them places. We have plans to go to theme parks and do other fun stuff, go to games and things like that. And we need that transportation. So that is our goal. Or if you know anyone who has a van and say, hey, the Legacy Bridges Foundation is looking for one, let's bless them with a van. We will gladly accept it. So definitely fill out the pledge cards, and one of our staff will kindly walk around and collect those from you all. But thank you so much again, and we appreciate you.